has been sent in by Rajinder Kumar Gaur, and he asks, why most of the fixed maturity plans are faring so poorly? Is it the end of the road for such schemes? He's stuck with three such schemes and wants your advice on this.
Well, fixed maturity plans, or FMPs as they are popularly known, have earned a bad reputation in the recent times, more so in the aftermath of the DHFL defaults and the SL Group's loan against shares fiasco. These were the kind of issuers within which many FMPs were found to have disproportionately high exposures, and they paid a price for it. They caused a lot of heartburn, they caused a lot of pain to investors, and when these bonds defaulted or delayed the payments, in turn, the FMPs had to default on their payments or delayed their payments to the investors, and they earned a lot of bad reputation because of this. In principle, I don't think that FMPs were a bad product category inherently. They were quite suitable for somebody who had a very defined time frame of investment to earn a predictable return. But as I said, perhaps some fund managers threw caution to the wind and basically violated the principles of prudence and diversification while building out the portfolios. And when these issuers defaulted, they paid a price for it. As things stand now, there are hardly any new FMPs hitting the market these days. So from that perspective, it is as good as a dead category for the time being. Now, what he can do with his existing investments in his FMPs, while theoretically speaking, there is an exit route available through the stock exchange, because all closed-end funds such as the FMPs are mandated to compulsorily list on a stock exchange to provide an exit window. But from a practical standpoint, there is not much liquidity in most FMPs, so that exit option may not be available to him. In the circumstances, there is really little that he can do but to continue holding them till their maturity. And actually, depending upon when these funds came out and when did he make these investments and how well they are managed, they may after all not turn out to be a bad investment from a yield perspective, given the kind of interest rate scenario we are in and what is the kind of yield that he would otherwise get on open-end debt funds. So from that perspective, they actually may not turn out to be a bad investments if he holds them till maturity.